And to help us make sense of the developments surrounding the 2022 elections, we are joined by political analysts Edna Ko and Ella Atienza. Good afternoon, professors, and thank you for joining us today.
Good afternoon.
All right, first off, you've heard perhaps our earlier reports about vote counting machine problems encountered in the elections, the long lines, and the possibility of people not being able to vote as the precinct is closing at 7 p.m. What do you make sense of these events?
I think COMELEC has to address these things very quickly. They have to also make sure that the process is very transparent. The manual feeding of the ballots that were not counted earlier because of the failure of the VCM. They have to assure the public that they are doing their best and everything will be done fairly and cleanly. Otherwise, there will be doubts about the results of the elections. And at the same time, also the COMELEC as well as the poll watchers and all these watchdogs should actually pay attention to all these reports about delays in the opening of the precincts, as well as some incidents of political violence and some accusations of vote buying. So these things have to be resolved quickly and fairly. Otherwise, there will be doubts in the minds of people about the conduct of the elections.
And Professor Edna Ko is also with us on the set, has echoed the same sentiments, saying that the recent developments, the faltering vote counting machines and the other election problems and glitches in the electoral processes is contributing to the mounting distrust over the election processes. What can you say about that, Professor Ko?
Good afternoon, Stanley and Denise. Thank you for the invitation. I do share the observation. Mm-hmm. Everybody, as we know, this is a very special election time for the Filipino people. Everybody is looking forward to the outcome of the election. And this morning, as I went to my voting place, immediately one of the disappointing, probably, things that I heard was that a lot of the machines are already off their order, and this is adding to the stress, I would say, of people. I mean, going through the labyrinth of the crowd as early as 6 in the morning, I was surprised people are just, and people pin so much hope in this election. That's why for the first time, I've never seen our precinct area that busy and that excited. But the atmosphere is actually affected by, you know, hanging on whether there's going to be a working machine. And for some people, including the senior citizens, have to wait on a very long queue. And I think the situation doesn't correspond to the excitement of the public, the voters, as they look forward to a worthy and honorable electoral process.
Dr. Edna, you just mentioned that a lot of people are coming into this elections with so much hope. They're met with disappointment. The senior citizens have been complaining about how they had to climb flights of stairs, lots of inconvenience. You know, this kind of distrust that Stanley also mentioned a while ago, how will this affect, I guess, the image of the COMELEC to the people and for the future elections to come here in the country?
Denise, my view there is that depends on where you sit. Mm-hmm. You consider the issue depending on, like a commissioner, for example, or COMELEC people would say, well, we'll do something about it, we'll respond to it. It's not very serious. I think it's like watering down an issue. But if you're a voter queuing under the heat of the sun and waiting for so long, and everybody, as I said, pins so much hope in this election, it's like being poured cold water under a warm season. And that's not quite what we hope the election would go. I mean, we have to level up in the manner that the people's expectations in the election are so high. So I think the kind of procedures and the services should equalize or should be equal to the amount of eagerness and the kind of respect that people give to this electoral process.
Yes, I'd like to go back to Professor Tienza. Professor Ko, of course, was talking about the difficulties of voting, holding supposed to be easier automated elections. Now, do you think all of these problems compounded could possibly result in perhaps disenfranchisement or a lower voter turnout?
Hi, Stanley. Yeah, I think I was also in line for more than 3 hours earlier. That's the reason as why I cannot join you in the studio. And looking at the people, many people would like to stay. They actually do not want to just leave their ballots to the people inside the polling precincts. And some have decided that they will come back at around 3 o'clock. They said they were assured that around 3 o'clock the voting vote counting machines will be available already. So they will go back. They really want to vote. But I also noted a few people in line who wanted to vote early this morning because they have to work. In that sense, these failures of the VCMs, the delays, can also lead to disenfranchisement of people who initially were willing to vote. They came very early. I interviewed some people in line, and they said they were there at around 5:40 and 5:40 a.m., as early as 5:40 a.m., and some of them cannot find their names. Some of them have difficulty looking for their precincts, and then some of them also have certain problems with VCM. So they're waiting for the VCMs to be repaired. So this can affect, of course, a number of people being disenfranchised, and their word is getting out that some VCMs are not functioning in certain precincts that may have a tendency of affecting people who have decided to vote later. But if some of them note that the VCMs are not working in their precincts, that might turn away a few people.
Professor Tienza, how do we find a solution for that disenfranchisement feeling?
Yeah, Denise, actually there were a lot of suggested reforms earlier, particularly when the cases of the COVID cases were very high. There were proposals in Congress to allow PWDs and the elderly to vote early. So we need a law for that, that they be included in early voting or absentee voting. At the same time, there were also suggestions that Congress pass laws that would allow mail-in voting, but these proposals were not passed. So I think now that we're faced with this situation again, that everything is done with long lines and we have VCMs malfunctioning, perhaps they can do an emergency resolution, maybe extend the hours. I know they have extended up to 7, but maybe they can extend further to accommodate people who really wanted to vote, but because of the delays and the failures of the VCMs, maybe they can extend further into the night. They should not close the voting precincts by 7 p.m.
That's right, Professors Tienza and Ko. Apparently, reality check, we're just 3.5 hours before the closing of precincts, and we're still getting reports that there are long lines outside schools and voting centers. And Professor Tienza, you mentioned there should have been other ways to do this. It's apparent, though, that this is the only way we know. We have agreed to hold the elections as far as Commission on Elections is concerned. What kind of reforms, Professor Ko, should the COMELEC adapt, given that this kind of situation is recurring. It's been happening in the past elections, and seemingly we're not even able to address all of these realities as of the moment.
What is a mystery to me, Stanley, is that Commission on Election has been doing this for forever.
Right.
I mean, we know that machines are old and that they can be imperfect, and that is what we call in governance anticipatory management. Did we anticipate this? So I think if there is any loophole at this point in time, they should try in 3.5 hours yet what they can do to redeem the situation. But the most redeeming factor here is, as we talk now, there are still people who are sending messages and are saying, we want to wait for the machine, for the replacement, so we can vote. They just keep the vote so sacred. And to me, reform is about the vigilance of the voters themselves, to be patient and to wait until the machine comes and for them to be told time is up. But there are many things going in my mind on matters of governance, because the standard procedures which COMELEC should be able to deliver are something that should constantly be a reform area. It is something that should challenge them, whether election day or even prior to election. The reform is in the aspect of modernizing the machine, the technology. How valuable can they make use of 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. optimizing and serving 65 million voters? It's not the same anymore,
right,
as the last time when we had 40 plus million. In other words, if there should be an adaptive Commission on Election, an innovative one, which is ready for change, ready for emergency, and cannot wait till like the old bureaucratic style of dealing with everything is normal. And therefore, I think that's a challenge for the reform in the commission. We cannot just say we wait, no? Because the election period is just a limited number of hours within a day. This is the only day where people will have to make their choice. So it's difficult to accept that we can just take things as a regular, a normal problem, because this is a particular instant that calls for immediate decision by those who lead an administrative unit called the Commission on Election.